His trip and his live comments from Vietnam as they happen. But now, my opening statement. Is it dangerous to be a Trump supporter? Well, it's unlike anything I've seen in my lifetime. With conviction and an air of condescension, the left so hates Donald Trump and those who support him that they sanction the use of violence against them. They are attempting to recast our legal system without authority to do so, without legislative sanction, and without judicial imprimatur. To them, the use of physical violence is legal, proper, and justified if they disagree with your politics. The very ones who call you fascists and label themselves anti-fascist or antifa are changing the rules, propagating a legal theory that is not only outrageously incorrect and an affront to democracy, it is an outright attempt at anarchy. Evidence. A man calmly asks whether players on a baseball field in D.C. are Democrats or Republicans. A documented Republican and Trump hater, he doesn't start shooting until he's told the players are Republicans. And Republican Congressman and Majority Whip Steve Scalise is shot and forever bears the scars of that hatred and violence. After the shooting, instead of a discussion of this issue of hatred, there's a concerted effort to claim the shooter was just a nut job. The mainstream media and the left more comfortable blaming a crazy man or guns for the actions of a leftist Trump-hating progressive. This guy wasn't crazy. That's an excuse to not deal with the left's hatred of the right. Had he been crazy, he would have been found so, or at least incompetent to stand trial when previously arrested. The man was in business. He had licenses for those businesses. He was focused, lucid, and clear in his attempt to commit violence against the right. Evidence. In California, a teacher at the Martin Luther King Middle School tells her class that it is okay to use violence against the right, and such is not a crime. Yvette, or Yvonne Falarca, who is so open about her hatred and use of violence that she's charged with inciting a riot and arrested for her actions, and she's a member of the leftist group By Any Means Necessary. She's caught on camera assaulting a member of a workers' party. And she and her counter-protesters chased, hit, and even stabbed members of that traditional worker party. And the Berkeley Unified School District has reinstated her this past fall at the middle school. And just last week, Rand Paul suffered 6 broken ribs by his liberal neighbor, whose lawyer claims the assault was about leaves. If it is determined by federal investigators now looking into this unprovoked attack that it was politically motivated, well, then this would just be another example of the left's actionable hatred. Antifa itself, the ones in the black ninja outfits and masks in order to prevent their ID and arrest, believe they are justified in not only destroying property and burning buildings, but also assaulting anyone who disagrees with their socialist agenda. And if that's not enough, law enforcement is also standing down, not detaining, not arresting, not stopping the violence. And amazingly, folks, the order actually coming from the top, from a chief of police, a sheriff, a superintendent, a governor, directing cops to violate their oath to protect victims and the public. The proof is in the pudding. After 12 hours of violence in Berkeley that involved individuals as well as property, only one arrest. And if you were in Washington, as I was on Inauguration Day, you know they aren't shy about it. Madonna at a microphone saying she was thinking of blowing up the White House. Kathy Griffin puts a vile picture of herself holding a bloody likeness of the president's head on social media. The goal of these haters is to normalize, incite, and mobilize hatred and turn it into violence. Now, OFA, Organizing for Action, once Obama for America, is a Democratic protest movement with Barack Obama at its helm, and it's reportedly busing protesters to events. And Hillary, of course, wants to be the head of the resistance. Let's be clear. The claim that words alone or beliefs justify violence is so far afield from the common law and our legal foundations that most people are smart enough to not even entertain or argue it. It's not just speech these organized, militant, self-anointed activists seek to shut down. They seek to upend the very rules upon which our criminal justice system is based. These Trump-hating progressives claim that assault is legitimate and justified, that it's okay to punch a fascist, and that their thinking is starting to become mainstream, folks. In 2016, Americans elected Donald Trump. We were tired of 8 years of a lawless Obama presidency. We believed that the outsider, Donald Trump, was just the one to bring back law and order and truth and justice. Little did we know that the law and order we craved wasn't just about enforcing the law, like violations that occurred before our very eyes by the Clintons, by Lois Lerner, Loretta Lynch, Eric Holder, and that lot. But instead, it's now about preventing a complete takeover of the justice system by infiltrating in the minds of millennials and militant forces that justice tolerates.